Yeah, we are finally getting towards the end of the NumPy stuff. I'm slowly running out of topics. There are only 3 videos left. However, this is an important one. It's about reshaping NumPy arrays. And this is specifically useful if we want to get our data into the right shape. This could be, for example, for reshaping a matrix into a vector, or a vector into a matrix. So I talked about that briefly in the introduction of this class in the very first lecture, where I talked about MNIST. So let's just assume, for simplicity, you have this array 28 by 28. So, and this 28 by 28 array, it's an image, basically. So there should be different pixel values, but just for simplicity, just assume each one here is a different pixel value. So we have this 28 by 28 image. And so the problem with that would be that we can't have a 28 by 28 matrix as a feature vector, because you learned the classifiers in scikit-learn, like K and N, they assume a feature vector, not a matrix for features. So what we can do is we can reshape that into a vector that should be 784 elements, right? So we 28 times 28 should be 784 elements. So we could reshape this one into a 784 element vector. So this would be one long vector, and then we can give it as a feature vector to K and N. So each training example would be one image, and each training example would have 784 features, for example. There's a simpler way using this approach, but I will show you briefly why that works and how that works. So I don't want to get ahead of myself here. So here, let's start with a simple example where we have a very simple toy data set instead of thinking of images. So this toy data set is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's a vector. And we can reshape that into 2 by 3 matrix here. Note that these numbers have to be correct. The product here has to sum up to the number of elements, the length of the array. We can't just do something like 3 and 3, because there are no 9 elements, there are only 6 elements, so this would throw an error. So you have to get the dimensions right. You can do 3 and 2, and you could even do 1 to 6. So this would, note this has no 2 brackets, so this would be 6 columns. Before it's just a one-dimensional vector, now it's a two-dimensional vector. A 2D array, it would be a matrix, it would be basically a column vector. And we can also do that the same way, making a row vector and so forth. But let's get back to this one here. So also, if we do the reshape, what happens is that we will create a memory view. So it will not create a new array, it will create a view onto that array. And it's related to what you learned in the previous videos when I talked about using slicing operations and indexing for creating memory views. So there's a function in NumPy that also allows us to double check that, but I think the NumPy developers state that this is not 100% accurate. It's most of the time accurate, but it may be wrong, so it's called may share memory and not just share memory. So, but yeah, this is one at least piece of evidence that these share memory, so the view, the reshaped one, and the original one. Yeah, getting back to the minus one here, so there's one little convenience function in NumPy, which is, I think, pretty handy in many applications. It's that it will guess the last axis. So it's kind of related to the degrees of freedom when you compute things in statistics. So you can, for example, if you know you have 6 elements and you put a 2 here, you know this can only be a 3, right? So there's no way this could be a 2, and there's no way it can be a 4, because 2 times 4 doesn't match up to 6, right? So there's only one way you can have that, and it's the 3 here. So minus 1 will also create exactly the same one here. And minus 1, 2, the same way, this will be replaced by a 3, because there's only one way, one number that we can put here, that's the 3, to get 6 elements. So you can think of this as a placeholder. So here the minus one acts as a placeholder, but please don't confuse that with, let's say, the minus one in indexing. So the minus one in indexing, that's not a placeholder, that's returning the last element. But in reshaping, minus one is like a placeholder. It's just helping basically the method to guess what dimension it is. Of course, it would also work if we have multiple dimensions. So if we have one, two, minus one, so the minus one would be again the three here, because this one would just be an empty dimension. So it is it works with an arbitrary number of dimensions. And we can also use reshape, I showed you that in the very beginning, to flatten an array. So if we have an array like this, we can call reshape to flatten it. So shape and reshape, what goes in here is basically the same. It's the number of elements on each axis. And if we only, so it's a comma separated stuff here. So if we only have one value, this means only we have one axis. And given that we, for example, here have six elements, there's actually only one way we can have one axis, and that is by putting a six here. So putting a six here is again also the same as minus one. However, in practice, just typing minus one is way more convenient, because then we don't have to memorize the number or the size. So we could also, if we want to write some general purpose code that should work on any array, we could also write this. I think it, sorry, it should be numpy.prod. You can also write like this, where this should give us, if I remember correctly, the product of what's in there. Let's try that first. Yeah, so it could also write it like that, same way, but I think there's no argument against it, that this is just nicer, simpler, and faster to write. I should also say there are different ways to flatten an array. So this is one way to do it, and this will create a memory view. There is another function that is called flatten that will also flatten an array. And there's also a function that is called revel. That's also flattening array. I think this one will create a memory view similar to this one, and this one will create a copy. That is maybe a good question for you to find out. So maybe I will make that a quiz question. So that would be a good question for you to find out. I will make this a little self-assessment quiz for this week as a question to find out which one is creating the copy and which one is the memory view. Lastly, about reshaping, last point is also we can concatenate arrays, so we can combine different arrays. So here I am just stacking along the first axis. So if we have an array like that, there's only one axis, right? So this is like just a column vector, so it will just append it. It's basically the same, if you think of Python lists, it's the same as doing this basically. Another way you can use that is if you have two axes. So this would be a case where we have two axes. So this is basically two-dimensional now. I can show it to you here. It's sometimes hard to overlook because it's not that easy to see that we have that. So we have basically three columns. And then we can use concatenate with axis zero to stack along the first axis. So I think what it will do is it will just stack another one below here. Let me check. I already had two. So if I have the original one, it will just create the one that I just set, two rows. And then what we can also do is we can stack by the columns. So this will be basically similar to this one. But to be honest, I always forget which one is doing which. So in practice, I would just always double check and make sure this is in actually doing what I want to do. So I have now two rows and three columns. So instead of having the basically one row and three columns, now I have two rows and three columns. And here I have six columns basically. So yeah, but I always tend to forget these things as well. So usually in practice, I always double check things just to make sure it's doing what I wanted to do. All right, next we will talk about NumPy comparison operators and masks. We briefly talked about masks before, but there are another cool set of features that are useful in connection with comparison operators and masks, which I will cover in the next video.